La 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 la. The Masked Boy. Oh my goodness. TM. Who's got the initials TM?
Terry Crews.
Oh, no. I don't even think we have anybody with the first initial T.
Tyler?
Not this group. Not this group. We'll have to figure it out. Oh my gosh. So I'm going to remind you, sir, that you are now in a classroom and it is time to behave accordingly. There's Georgia. All right, so let's start. So I will take attendance when you guys start to work independently. I thought that there was somebody that signed on with like the boy who something or other. I don't know who that was. Let's see. Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to continue working with the tail today. So I have some more multiple choice practice posted in classroom. Let me share my screen and show you how to get there. Magic wand, where are you? There you are. All right, so in classroom, if you go to classwork is the easiest way to get there. And there, go to the tail. And then there's a new thing, says the tail, and it says MC for multiple choice, 6 through 10. You are working on that. What else do you need open when you're doing the multiple choice?
The text.
Text. What else do you need to do as you're doing the multiple choice so Mrs. Jost doesn't have to take her bullhorn out like this and tell you after the fact? Underline and label it with the question number, right? Okay, so you should be doing that as you're answering the questions. Okay, so we're going to give you 10 minutes because that seemed to be enough time. So it's 8:06. At 8:16, we will all stop and we will go over the questions together. Tomorrow, the questions that you have to do, I will grade. Okay, questions, problems, issues. All right, go for it. Restart the recording, yay. All right, so let's start to go over these, please. Why can't I get that out of the way? All right. So again, you're gonna have to look at my screen and you're gonna have to look at your screen. And I know that's a lot to maneuver because it's like, oh my goodness. But you're probably gonna wanna split your screen now between my screen and yours. Am I even sharing my screen? I'm not, because I was doing some other things. Let's try that again. Here we go. Okay, so number 6 reads, Tasha breaks one of her mother's rules when she A, washes the dishes, B, leaves the block, C, plays on the block, or D, helps Junior vacuum. Maddie, what'd you pick for that one? Say it again. Okay, so give me the letter and then the answers. And especially if you're wearing a mask, it's hard to understand you. And not just you, but everybody. Leaves the block. B leaves the block. Very good. So let's highlight B. And then Maddie, can you tell us where in the text you found your proof for that? So I'll go back to the text. So what page in the text? It's going to be towards the middle of the story, right? So what did you underline in the text? There's a couple of places you could underline to show that she's breaking a rule of her mom's. Okay, let me ask you this way. Did you underline anything to prove number six in the text, yes or no? You did. Okay, could you tell me what page it's on? Did you label it with number six? Well, that's a problem. That's why you can't find it so easily. Who's got it? Okay, you got to label it with the question number. So when we go over these, it goes a little bit faster. Help us out, Haley. Go ahead. Okay, do you see my page? The page I'm on? I'm on page six of the CAMI. Where do I go from there? Up or down? Down. So I'm going to go to page seven. Well, what page am I on? Am I still on this page? Okay, so where on this page, what did you underline on this page? Okay, so we sort of underlined some things yesterday in that. Let me make sure I get a different color for today. We'll use green because it's, yeah. So Junior tells her, hey, this is still not the block and you know it. You're disobeying mom, right? Okay, there's other places. I mean, like just even above that, right here, this could be number six.
On page three, it says, Tasha, I'm depending on you, don't leave the
block. When mom gives her the direction, right? Okay, good. So it's important that not only you underline it, but you label it with a question number, okay? So that way when we're going over it, we could find it really quickly. If you were doing this just by yourself, I wouldn't care if you did it, but for class purposes, it's kind of helpful. Okay, number seven, in the park, Tasha gets very angry with Junior when A, he trips her as she's jumping rope, B, threatens to tell her mother about getting lost, C, begs repeatedly to play with the other kids, or D, runs back to the apartment to hide. Heather, what'd you get for that one?
I got A.
Okay, say what A says. Okay, trips her as she's jumping rope. And what's your proof? So let me highlight that. And we'll go back to the text. Guys, obviously you should be correcting your work, keeping track of the ones. So where do I go from here, Haley? I mean, Heather, sorry. I haven't done that in a long time. Page seven, okay. So page seven in CAMI, okay. At the end of the page, oh yeah, here we go. Suddenly Junior jumped in the ropes and she's screaming at him. And you could even probably pick the stuff on the next page, right? There's your proof, good job. All right, number eight, this is one where we could just, you know, use the information right in the question because the text is quoted. It says, what can you infer, what can you tell about Tasha's feelings for her brother from this passage in the tale? And the passage is, please let me find him. I will play any kind of game he wants. I'll never yell at him again. Does that mean that A, Tasha resents her brother? B, Tasha is afraid of her brother? C, Tasha loves her brother deeply? Or D, Tasha is annoyed with her brother? Caden Sweeney, what'd you get for number eight? Turn your mic on, dude.
C.
Tasha loves her brother deeply. Very good. What's your proof in the passage? What'd you underline up here?
I will play any kind of game he wants. I'll never yell at him again.
Yeah, or you could even do like the whole thing. Like she's pleading with God to intervene. Help me. All right, good job. Number nine, what can you infer? What can you tell from this passage in the tale? We heard a rustling in the bushes and grabbed each other. Probably just a bird, I said, trying to sound brave. Does that mean that Tasha's frightened, that she's not frightened, Junior is hiding in the bushes, or Naomi is scared, more scared than Tasha? Alex, bird, what did you get for number nine?
I got Tasha is frightened.
So that would be A, right? And what did you highlight in the text above?
Hold on.
Okay, hang on. I got to turn you up because you're not coming through very loudly. Say again, what did we highlight up here in the quoted text?
Probably just a bird, I said, trying to sound brave.
Yeah, or just like trying to sound brave would do it, right? Because it's showing that she's not brave. Good. All right, number 10. The big brown and gray shape that frightens Tasha is A, a wild dog, B, a dead tree trunk, C, a lost child, or D, a flock of birds. Dev? Would be B, a dead tree trunk. Would you underline in the text? Then you didn't do the assignment correctly. You need to go back. Guys, I don't know how many times I have to say this, okay? But when Mrs. Jost gives you a direction out loud in class and says, go back to the text and underline your proof and label it, I really want you to do that. Why? Because even if this is easy for you, at some point in your life, you're gonna read a text that's gonna be harder for you and when you're gonna have to answer questions about it, right? So doesn't it make sense to get into the habit of going back to the text now and just doing that as a strategy? I mean, I do that. I read these stories like for years already. You're not paying attention. You're looking out the window and I'm talking basically to you because you just told me you didn't do what you were supposed to do. Mm-hmm. Okay. So I'm trying to like help you train yourself for when things get a little bit more difficult. So if you're not going back to the text, you're not harming me, you're harming you. It is a good strategy. It is proven to work. I've seen it work with my own students. Uh-huh. Really? Okay. So does somebody else have the proof for number 10? Haley, help us out so we can move on. On page 10. So Devin, I haven't seen you go back to the text or manipulate your screen at all. So I'm assuming even though we're going over this as a class and I said, make sure you're doing what I'm doing, you haven't done anything. So do you have anything underlined in your text? Yes or no? No. Yes or no? Do you have anything underlined in the text? Yes or no? Okay. So in other words, you didn't do anything I told you to do. Haley, I'm sorry. Go ahead. But that doesn't tell me what it is. That tells me what she's afraid of. Where does it tell me what it is? Where does she find out? Oh, here it is. A little bit further down. She laughed. Look what scared us. It's a dead tree trunk. Was that number 10? Okay. So there's five of them. They're worth 20 points apiece. Did anybody get them all right?
Yep. I got them all right.
I got them all right.
Okay, one wrong is 80%, two wrong is 60%, which is not a passing grade. Okay, all right, very good. Any questions about those multiple choice questions? All right, so the next thing we're gonna do, what I need you to do is go back to classroom, keep the text open, okay? Go back to classroom, go back to classwork, the tail, like mine's already up. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna go down and you're going to open up the plot diagram we've been working on. So open that up and you're gonna have to split your screen with my screen. So I'll give you a sec to do that. And somewhere I need to fix this for my next class. Okay. All right. So let me zoom in here. Okay. Everybody good? Need a minute? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, a couple of kids need another minute or two, so hang on. So I'm just gonna start talking while people are setting up. Okay, we've been working on a plot diagram. The plot diagram basically is this big black heavy line that looks like a mountain, like somebody's climbing the mountain. And you have something called the exposition or the initiating conflict, which in this story is Tasha finds out she has to watch Junior all summer. And then we're gonna fill in the rising action, climbing up the mountain to the climax, or the turning point. I forgot in first period yesterday because I was probably half asleep, but you know, climax and turning point are what I know that as, but 21st century kids, you guys, I got a better way for you to remember it. OMG, right? It's the OMG moment. It's the moment in the story where everybody goes, oh my God, what's gonna happen? Right? So you can add that OMG to that box and climax, because I think for you guys, your generation, it's easier to remember it that way. Okay? The OMG moment. It's the peak where everything, you know, oh my goodness, or the turning point. So we said in this story, the turning point or the OMG is like, Junior's missing. What's going to happen? Oh my God, right? And then you have something called falling action that leads to the resolution. And if in the resolution box right next to the word resolution, we can add solution, that might help you remember what the resolution is. The resolution is how the problem at the beginning gets resolved. And we said in this case that Tasha finds out that taking care of Junior isn't so bad and that she loves him, right? Okay, so today we're going to fill in the rising action and the falling action. When I do plot diagrams, I like to fill in my three key points first. I like to fill in my exposition, my climax, and my resolution, and then the rest of it shouldn't be so difficult, right? So after Tasha finds out that she has to watch Junior all summer long, what's the next like big event in the story that moves the story along?
She leaves the block.
That's not the next one, Haley. Okay, but what moves the plot along? We're doing a plot diagram. What helps the story move from one point to the next? She finds out she has to watch her brother, and then mom lays the law down, right? And then what does Junior do when mom lays the law down? He's very literal, right? So in this first box, we're gonna like combine those two things. I don't know why there's a T after that action, but whatever. We can get rid of that. Okay, so we could say mom gives instructions and Junior, and we can abbreviate Junior, Junior follows them literally. I don't know why a couple of them. And literally means he's doing exactly what they're being told, right? Like, you tell me to be quiet, I can't. You tell me to shut up, I can't answer the intercom because I can't talk. He's being an itch. The intercom. We talked about that the other day. Yep, we talked about that the other day. Okay, guys, we don't have a lot of time and we need to finish this today. Okay, so you need to type fast. What I'll do is I'll go over it and then I'll post it. I'll post my copy in Classroom for you and then you can copy it from there. Yeah. I can't make it any more bigger than it already is. But what somebody said, if you go up to something on your screen, you can zoom in, but I don't know how to do that. Okay, so then
if you go to the magnifying glass,
okay, go
it's to the magnet,
and click on that on my screen.
There's three dots on the top right corner.
The three dots on the top right corner, and then what, Alex?
And then you go and you see, and it says zoom, and then you go all the way until everybody can see it.
Yeah.
So, yeah, but that zooms your whole screen out.
Okay. Like I did that. So you're gonna have to manipulate it. What I'll do is I will post this in Classroom, but I do wanna fill in these boxes so that we could talk about theme, and we're probably gonna run out of time. So the rising action, next, mom gives instructions, Junior follows literally. The next big thing that happens is Tasha decides to go off the block. Like that, you know, is kind of an important thing. And she plays with her friends. And then in the next rising action, she finds out there's a wild dog, right? Wild dog! And then Junior goes missing. Please know that you're gonna have to fill out one of these for the next story we do for a grade. What I just said was, please understand that the next story that we do, you will have to fill out a plot diagram for a grade. So if you don't understand something, you know, you need to ask. All right, so then Junior, the climax is Junior goes missing, and then the falling action is, you know, there's a search for Junior. Right, and we could put a slash there, and Tasha prays out loud. Slash, and she finds Junior. There's not enough boxes in here. And she's gonna wring his neck. And then I think the next thing is that, you know, Junior gets to keep the dog. And Tasha's friends play at her house or something like that. And then we said yesterday the resolution was that taking care of Junior isn't so bad. So once you finish typing, and I know I'm asking you to type a lot, kids usually have to write this. We still have to fill in what the theme is, the message or the lesson, and we also have to fill in the climate or the mood down here. I would say the climate or the mood is heartwarming. Like, this is a heartwarming story, right? She can't stand her brother, but she finds out that she really loves him, right? When she thinks she's gonna lose him. So we could fill that in. So I think that there are a lot of different themes to this story. And normally what I do is I have kids talk about it between themselves, like I'll pair you up really quickly, and but we don't have time for that, especially with breakout rooms, because, you know, it takes 10 minutes for the thing to connect. So what could some possible lessons of this story be? Haley? Is your mic on?
Maybe you have to be like, you have to be like nice.
Wait.
Echo.
Yeah, try again.
Maybe you have to be like nice, like be nice to your siblings and they'll be nice back to you.
Be nice to your siblings and they'll be nice to you.
She realizes that she has to like be
specific
about what she says to
her
brother.
Oh, maybe she realizes that you have to be careful about what you say to people.
Okay. Haley, can you mute yourself?
I've never heard that one before. So when you talk about themes, you want to talk about like the bigger picture. So you're taking this idea that like she told him to get lost, knowing that he takes everything literally. So she should have been more careful with her words. That's a really good one. You gotta mute yourself after you're done talking. So I think that's a good one, Kira. I've never heard that one before. What about like you don't appreciate things until they're gone, right? Any one of those works, right? This story is jam-packed full of things. Which one we want to put in our box? I don't care. Be nice to your siblings, why? No, but why is that like the bigger theme? What? How about if I hear from, how about, where's Bella or Paige? Can one of you tell me what you think the theme is?
I really think it is like.
Yeah. That's
cool. Like, you don't realize things until they're gone.
Okay, you don't appreciate things until you're gone. That's what I had on my
plate. Yeah.
Let's put that down. So in this box, we're going to do appreciate the things you have, things or people, right? You have in your life. Something like that. So themes are more general. You need to go put that in your locker right now, buddy. Please. Okay, so I know that was the bell guy, so I'm gonna have to go. So there is a chance that I'm not going to be in school tomorrow because I'm going to get my second shot and people seem to, vaccination, people seem to be having more reaction to that one. So if I'm not here, you're going to do multiple choice questions tomorrow for a grade and turn them in. And then also I'll put some vocabulary, not graded, but just some for practice in case we need that. All right, so I would say, is there anybody that didn't finish copying all the information off of here? Caden, did you get it all? You copied everything that I copied on my plot diagram? Okay, so what I'll do is I'll take this copy and later today I will post this as an example. Okay, make sense? All right, so guys in Zoom land, I have to go. Have a lovely day. Thanks for playing school. See you later.
Bye.
Bye.
Deuces.
All right, if they'll let me.